We want to determine the equation of the line passing through the given two points. We want the equation to be in slope-intercept form. So to do this, we can work with slope-intercept form or point-slope form of a line. In this video, we'll only be using slope-intercept form of a line, which is the form y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope of the line and b is the y-intercept of the line. And since we're given two points on the line, we can use the equation m equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1 to find the slope. So if we call these coordinates the 1s and these coordinates the 2s, this would be x sub 1, y sub 1, and this would be x sub 2, y sub 2. So now using the slope formula, y sub 2 minus y sub 1 would be negative 2 minus negative 3. And x sub 2 minus x sub 1 would be 4 minus negative 2. So if we simplify this, this becomes negative 2 plus 3, and this becomes 4 plus 2, so our slope is equal to 1/6. So let's go ahead and substitute 1/6 in for m. We know that our equation must be y equals 1/6 x plus b. So the second step is going to be to determine the value of b, or the y-intercept. Well, if we look back at the two points that we're given, neither of these are the y-intercept because notice neither of the x-coordinates are equal to 0. But these points are on the line, which means if we substitute the x and y-coordinates into the linear equation, it must satisfy the linear equation. So what we can do is select one of these points, substitute the x-coordinate here and the y-coordinate here, which will then allow us to solve for b. Now it doesn't matter which point we use, let's go ahead and just use this second point. So we'll substitute negative 2 for y and positive 4 for x. So we're going to have negative 2 must equal 1/6 times 4, but I'll write 4 as 4 over 1 plus b. And now we can solve this equation for b. We'll first determine this product here. Notice there's a common factor of 2. There's 2 2's in 4 and 3 2's in 6. So we have negative 2 equals, this would be 2/3 plus b. So now we'll subtract 2/3 on both sides. So we'd have b equals, this would be negative 2 and 2/3. Or if we want, we can convert this to an improper fraction. We'd have b equals the negative fraction with a denominator of 3. And then for the numerator, we'd have 3 times 2 plus 2, which would be 8. So now that we know the value of b, using this equation here, we'll substitute negative 8/3 for b. So the equation of our line would be y equals 1/6 x plus negative 8/3, but you normally won't see the linear equation written in this form. Plus negative 8/3 is equivalent to subtracting 8/3. So you'll normally see the equation of the line written as y equals 1/6 x minus 8/3. Let's go ahead and verify this graphically. Notice how the y-intercept is negative 8/3 or negative 2 and 2/3 as we see here. And then to verify the slope, if we select two points on the line with integer coordinates, for example, this point here and this point here, notice how if we wanted to move from this point to this point, we'd have to go up 1 unit and right 6 units. Which does verify that the vertical change would be positive 1 and the horizontal change would be positive 6, giving us a slope of positive 1/6.